Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Smoke Learning Channel. This video will start looking at some of the ins and outs of 2D text in Autodesk Smoke. The text tool is available as a timeline effects in the sequence, or you could use the text node in Connect Effects to integrate a 2D title into your composites. Let's start off in the sequence and progress from there. Now you can apply the text timeline effects directly to clips in the sequence, or you could place the text in a gap segment on the empty layers above the edit. I actually prefer to use the latter method because it separates the text from the edit. So this means you can have your title across multiple shots and move it independently of the edit. It's all about flexibility. So click the Track Plus button to add a new video layer to the sequence. Now, even though it is an empty video track, you can still select it and apply effects to it. So with the gap segment selected, press Ctrl Tab to bring up the effects ribbon. Click the text button to add the text to the gap segment. In the mini toolbar, you will see the basic text controls appear to make quick and easy titles. For example, click New Layer. I'll just type Smoke. In the basic controls, you can increase the size. And you can also set the horizontal alignment of the text. I'll set mine to center. You can also change the font with the basics menu, but we'll come back to fonts a little later. You can also click the text pulldown menu and change other available settings. For example, I will choose the outlines and shadow menu. Just click on the shadow button to enable a simple shadow behind the text. Now, if you want to edit the text after adjusting the title, you need to set the text mode from move to edit. Just start typing and the typing changes will start appearing in the player. As soon as you start scrubbing the sequence, the text mode switches back to move to re-enable the keyboard shortcuts. So that's the quick and easy title. For more detailed text controls, click the Editor button to enter into the Advanced Editor. To ensure you can work in real time with the text layers, ensure that the preview options are set to No Preview. This means that the titling won't be cached as you work, and it speeds up interactivity. Now the text tool works in layers, and you can click New Layer as many times as you want. We'll just stick to one layer to keep this straightforward. Similar to what you saw in the sequence, the two basic modes are Edit and Move. The button is located to the bottom left of the interface, and you can toggle this mode by pressing the Escape keyboard shortcut. So while in Edit mode, you can edit the text layer. It uses the same idea of text selection compared to any word processing application. Only when your text is selected will you be able to make attribute changes to the text. Starting on the left, you have the text properties like fill, outline, and shadow. You can enable these options by clicking on their buttons and adjusting any corresponding sliders. In the middle, you have the font choices, text attributes, and alignments. And finally on the right, you have positioning. This is split into two sections. First, you have layer positioning, and then you have positioning of selected characters. You could use this to create intricate text animations in your titles. Coming back to the actual title, you can create this in three ways. Firstly, you could manually type the title in the sequence or the advanced editor. Secondly, you could click the Load button and load an external text file. Or the last method is simply to copy and paste from another application using Command-C and Command-V. So click Delete All and we can start again. I'll just switch to the text edit application where I have a plain text file. If you were importing the file into Smoke with the second method, it would need to be saved with a TXT file extension. However, in this case, just select the text and press Command-C to copy the selection. Switch back to Smoke. Click a new layer by either clicking on the player or clicking New Layer. Press Command V to paste the text. You need to have an editable text layer in order to copy and paste text into Smoke. Now let's select the text and change the font. Click the discrete font to enter into the file browser. The first place you land up is in Smoke's own font folder. Smoke is also only looking for Type 1 font. Most people use TrueType, so change the option in the pull-down menu. Looking at the subdirectories, there is a folder titled System Fonts. This is a link to the main font directories of your system. So if you click it, it should give access to all the fonts installed on the Mac. If you have installed fonts into your own Mac user, you will need to seek them out manually through the folders. Concerning the current view, if you see titles and not the thumbnails, change the view mode at the top left of the screen to Proxies. The first time you load these fonts, the thumbnails might be grayed out. So just click Generate Proxy and the thumbnails will refresh. If you have hundreds of fonts installed, this will take some time, but you should only need to do this once. Select any font you like, and it will display your text at the bottom of the screen. If you want to see different text in the preview window, click the text preview and change the type. This is just for previewing the font, and it will not affect the original text in the layer. Now click Load to load the font onto the layer. Let's go ahead and center the paragraph alignment of the text using the pull-down menu. To finish off, we'll format the text for a final look. Switch back to the edit mode with Escape. First, change the size of the text. Now just select the U character. I'll increase the font size to make the first letter stand out. However, I want to resize the entire title to fit better with the background. So once again, I'll select all the text. If I now drag the font size, all the adjustments I made will be flattened into a single font size value. So press Command Z to undo the last action. To resize the text in proportion, go to the Text Mode pull-down menu and choose Resize from the list. The size value is replaced with Resize. Dragging the slider will proportionately resize the text, but keep the text margins at the same length. This is different from actually scaling the layer, which will also affect the margins. Please note that there is also a re-kerning option in the Text pull-down menu to help control the text with different kerning values. Now I'd like the title to be in the center of the screen. You could use the layer controls on the right to manually set the center, but there is a proper way. Change the text mode in the pull-down menu to Safe Title. This will allow Smoke to align the title in the frame using the title safe of the frame. Press 5, and the title will be aligned in the center of the screen. Just to elaborate on this further, if I select the Safe Title option again and press 8, the text is aligned to the top of the safe frame. And finally, the number 2 on your keyboard will align the text to the bottom of the safe title. As you have seen, there are quite a few options to try with text, but there are loads to come. Coming soon, we'll look at placing text on a 2D path for enhanced topography effects. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.